A fun fact for that, National Hispanic Heritage Month was first celebrated for a week long in 1968. Then 20 years later in 1988, they signed it into law by President Ronald Reagan to be a whole month period long, so from September 15 to October 15. September 15 is a very important day in a lot of the Latin American countries because it's their Independence Day. Countries like Costa Rica, Honduras, El Salvador, Nicaragua, and Panama. And also there's countries like Mexico and Chile that celebrate their Independence Day in September 16 and September 18, respectively. And also we have a Columbus Day, or El Día de la Raza, that's celebrated October 12th, that falls within that 30-day period that is celebrated.
So the difference is that Hispanics are people who come from Spanish descent, and so this includes Central America, South America, and the Caribbean, and it excludes Brazil, and it includes Spain. Where Latinos does include Brazil and excludes Spain, it includes Caribbean, Central America, and South America. It's a little more inclusive in terms of the Americas. A fun fact is that if you're North America, you're gonna be talking about like, hey, I'm Hispanic, but if you talk to another Hispanic person, you talk about the country you're from. So the contribution of Hispanics goes all the way back to the Civil War. And currently we have 16% active duty military that are serving, and this number has doubled in the past two decades. It means a lot to me, and I'm pretty sure it means a lot to you, Javi. It gives us a chance to talk about all the accomplishments that Hispanics have done to this country. And it also gives us a chance to talk about the barriers that we face currently.
Yeah, and this is one of the things as us Vice Lead and Leads will start talking about in our Hispanic Special Emphasis Program. So we want to make sure that all the community here at NSWC PCD is proactively participating throughout the year that we'll be serving as.